reaching for her, trying to make her act. It was a distress call. Faden sensed a drowning man, a hunger in the dark. Investigation sector.
Investigation sector, huh? We should check this out.
Here?
Guess not.
I just realized like my mic was muted, right? But yeah, shit man, Alan Wake is in this game. That's insane. But yeah, I'll start reading this again. So, per authorization from Mr. Kirkland, internal investigations D084-5 was launched into the ethical practices of Dr. Casper Darling, head of research. Despite the accounts of anonymous people regarding inhumane treatment of a person currently housed in the Bureau, our official findings regarding this were inconclusive. Numerous obstacles arose during this investigation, the majority of something sector personnel seemed to be wholly unaware of any such something contained there. One something confirmed something's code name to be something, but all files pertaining of that name were inaccessible, being classified under the highest clearance level. Investigators were similarly blocked off from entering the something research wing, so that's going to be like the that place that we're going to, right, to interview its staff. The matter was further complicated by the lack of clarity on whether non-human paranormal entities warrant humane treatment. While this investigation cannot address any changes against Dr. Darling, we do recommend an investigation into parapsychological research or whatever it's called. Cool. All right, yeah, so fucking that
seems
was crazy.
A lot more
right?
Crowded than the rest of the Bureau.
You know, I was saying, like, you know, like, is it going to be a case of this is another one of Alan Wake's books? Like, he's writing about Jesse and all of this. Cool Easter egg. So, Dr. Dennis, a request came through recently from an FBI agent asking for all our files on Bright Falls, specifically on the disappearance of the author, Alan Wake. Per the Interagency Information Exchange Agreement, I had some paper pushers gather up a folder of all the pre-approved files. Don't worry, all of the inappropriate material is either missing or redacted. But I'm writing to let you know that we received a request from a special agent named Alex Casey. Sounds familiar, right? That's because Alex Casey is the name of the fictional detective in those hard-boiled crime books Alan Wake wrote. Pretty interesting that an FBI agent sharing a name with the most famous character Wake wrote is looking into a case dealing with a writer's fiction coming true. I think this is worth looking into, but what's your opinion? Just give the word and I'll start surveillance on this guy. Man, I really wish I played Alan Wake, like, again, more recently. Missing agents. Mr. Kirkland, here are the latest agents confirmed missing, presumed dead from the containment breach yesterday. So, Agent John Connor, Ezra Cruz, Caroline Dempsey, bunch of names, Derek Shaw. Okay, don't know any of those names. Letters of condolence will be delivered to you to sign prior to sending them to their families. You'll be updated as soon as additional confirmations are made. Also, per your request, a network engineer checked how many cases were backed up digitally. Unfortunately, a large number of active investigations were not archived yet, and the only hard copies of reports exist behind the firebreak. They're lost, I'm afraid. Factor supplement. Okay, so supplementary materials. Note, miscommunications led to the local coroner examining the body of William Borough. So it's a white male, male Caucasian? A Caucasian male. So, 33-year-old man found dead on his property, per police reports. Remains obtained from coroner's office also included blood, urine, bile, stomach contents, and bone fragments. So, autopsy findings, blunt force injuries to the head, lacerations to the left ear slash cheek, blunt force injuries, extremities, dislocation of the right knee, complete avulsion of the right upper extremity with associated fracture of the proximal right humerus, extensive trauma to the abdominal region, complete avulsion of multiple organs including stomach, heart, liver, pancreas, kidney, and portions of the large and small intestine, all missing from scene. Conclusion is my opinion that Mr. Borough's death is not the result of mechanical accident. As claimed by authorities, the removal of organs is consistent with animal attacks. Okay. Man, there are so many documents here. Resignation letter. So, to whom it may concern, it is with great anger and regret that I tender my resignation as head of investigations for the Federal Bureau of Control. I do this in protest of the rampant disregard for my department. Something my staff cannot continue to work in these conditions. Previous requests and warnings have fallen on deaf ears, so I must now rely on my actions to speak louder than my words ever could. I blame the situation on our something who has routinely ignored my request for assistance in reclaiming the parts of the investigation sector lost to the hiss loose inside. I will never forget the screams of brave agents begging for us to open that firebreak. I will carry that shame for the rest of my days. The something has failed. The Bureau has failed his agents. I shall never forgive him for that. The something has failed his agents. I shall never forgive him for that. Sincerely, William Kirkland. So, I don't know what they're talking about. So, but maybe it's the archives. Because I know the firebreak is like down there, right? So I don't know. I'm not gonna open that yet. I think there's some more documents lying around. It's a staffing issue. Mr. Dennis, so yes, there's an increase in AWE cases, and yes, it would be a good idea to put together a special task force to examine exactly why that is. However, it seems that a tiny little detail has slipped through the cracks. We don't have the damn staff. If you expect us to detect, investigate, and process more AWE cases, you need to give us more people. It's simple math. Between the staff we lost in the Hartman thing and the one who left for the other departments after Kirkland quit, we're barely managing to keep up with the workload. Hell, just filing the paperwork for all the altered items we left behind in the sector has been an ordeal. Another thing, and this is going to sound paradoxical, but we have an overcrowding situation. This lobby isn't meant to accommodate a whole sector's worth of staff. We put forward a motion to move investigations to a more suitable location months ago. It better not still be sitting on your desk. The people are getting restless, and Kirkland's interim replacement, it's your job to handle it. Best regards, Agent Grayson. Okay, any more documents? The stairs going that way. I think I should do the stairs. That seems like the way, right? Documents. Cauldron Lake update. That's from fucking Alan Wake, right? Dear Chief Investigator Dennis, it's happened again, third time this year. Something certainly has it out for our something. Could be raccoons. The locals certainly complain about them enough, but why the hell would raccoons keep going after a monitoring station? Doesn't add up. Anyway, I've got a bureau tech going to the site next week to take a look. Next to the list of recurring problems is the staff at the Lake House Research Station. How am I supposed to effectively keep an eye on Cauldron Lake if they won't let me see any data? Hell, I don't even know what they're researching out there. We need to petition them again to share their info with investigations agents. It's only a matter of time before this something hits again, and I want it to be prepared. And I want to be prepared. Anyway, if anyone at HQ asks why the Bright Falls report is a little thin this month, let them tell them it's because we couldn't take any readings. In the meantime, I might invest in some raccoon traps. Sincerely, Agent Estevez. Okay, so that's the ground slam. So many documents, man. Alright, per authorization from Mr. Kirkland, something was launched into the something of director Zakaria Trench. A recent change in something witnessed in director Trench could include aggressive personalities when something with other staff, when communicating with other staff has been observed. However, this investigation is aimed at interpreting this issue rather than proving it. Notable something between Director Trench and Dr. Darling has been witnessed by numerous Bureau staff, although both declined to meet for an interview on the matter. Witness accounts suggest that arguments centered around the dimensional research wing and the something kept inside. However, no evidence exists to confirm Director Trench's something as anything more than interpersonal disagreements. This investigation has concluded that Director Trench's behavior is not indicative of any something and that his fitness to lead is not in question. Refer to file something for the full report. Oh, it sounds like Trench and Darling started having some problems. Okay, so Kirkland, I'm growing tired of your blatant attempts to lay your incompetence at my doorstep. I know you want this to be true, but you are head of investigations. This failure is your responsibility. What did you think would happen, holding a dangerous specimen in investigations? The containment sector exists for a reason. They are better trained and better equipped for this type of work. In fact, they have admirably taken on certain NWE monitoring responsibilities that your staff are no longer capable of. This happens more and more now. And don't think your petty internal investigations have gone past my notice. You are a worm. Everything I've done has been for the benefit of the Bureau. The Prime Candidate Program only failed because of Darling. You are both failures. Plotting against me, you are traitors, but the truth will emerge out of you. You are choosing to become my enemy, Kirkland. You don't want to be. Zakaria Trench, director of. Okay, so Trench had beef with Kirkland too. Dr. Ryan Underhill is a professor at the University of Woodrow in the UK. Never heard of that uni. Where she teaches biology with a focus on botany. Dr. Underhill once worked with the Bureau as a parabotanist stationed in the research sector of the Oldest House. She served with no incidents or demerits and is praised by those who formerly worked with her, including Dr. Darling. Dr. Underhill has no known connections to paracriminal organisations or any record of breaching her NDAs since leaving the Bureau. Her civilian behaviour has been ideal, with the exception of an ongoing personal relationship with Dr. Darling that appears to have become during the time as co-workers in the research sector and revisited intimately ever since. Depending on the duration of her work in the Oldest House, it may be required to have both parties sign a relationship clearance form. This investigation has found no compelling reason to deny Dr. Darling's request to offer Dr. Underhill an interim position with the aim of finding a solution to the mould threshold issue. Okay, shit. So, is Raya Underhill like that woman? That the other guy, like, you know, he's got like the two, he's got like those two things, right? The assistant. So maybe she is the female one, because there's a whole thing about like the other guy liking her, and then she's like got her eyes on Trench and shit. You know, I was getting like these weird vibes. I'm really, really interested now, so I want to find. I want to find it, man. Oh, fuck it, I could be there forever. There's so many documents to go through. Okay, so. Okay, I can't believe that worked.
It's not working.
I can't believe
probably
that didn't
lose
work.
Lose power core somewhere.
All working now? Nope. What's missing the battery? Is that a document I saw? Shit, I can't believe I actually managed to get through there. Keystone inspection. Mr. Kirkland, we stopped at Keystone on our way to the target AWE like you asked. I'm sending my report directly to you to try to keep a lid to this Grumman Morales desertion issue. We didn't find any sign of them here, given their records, it is possible they've switched teams, like you suspected, but I don't think that's the case. An event definitely occurred here in Keystone, and I think Grumman and Morales got caught up in it. The entire population has vanished into thin air. Reminds me of the Ordinary case, but that was just the adults, if I'm remembering the file correctly. This is different. I think our guys are casualties, not traitors. If it was an AWE, it seems to be over. We've walked through the whole town, and the only strange thing we noticed were markings on various buildings. Two overlapping circles with a dot in the shared space could be unrelated. We'll show you the pictures when I get back. In the meantime, you should send a team out here to cordon this place off and maybe get some comms guys working on a cover story. Sincerely, Agent Keenum. Oh. Tired, dude. Alright, so I found my loose power core. Also found another document. Ethics investigation. Per authorization from Mr. Kirkland, internal investigation P1429 was launched into the legality of the Prime Candidate Program. FPC. Since all known subjects relevant to the investigation used executive privilege to decline interviews, very little first-hand information was gathered. However, anonymous sources and documentation declassified by Mr. Kirkland both paint an alarmingly clear picture of systematic something and something and something were brought into the oldest house and placed under something's examination and tested with the aims of appointing one as director upon maturity. This program has produced no successful cases and only resulted in the traumatic something of paranormally inclined something. Not only is this a breach in the Ash Act, but it flies in the face of basic human rights. The investigations team the Prime Candidate Program and recommends that it be terminated immediately. Unequivocally. Containment procedure item is not in bureau custody, non known. Description altered effect: a Frank Elk tractor, olive green, dried blood on the grill when last seen. Item is capable of vocalized responses or growls and unmannered locomotion. Considered highly aggressive and dangerous. So the tractor fucked that dude up, right? Hello. The background. The item first came to the Bureau's attention after the death of William Borough, owner of Borough Farms, a farm outside of Trenton, Texas. Local authorities arrived on scene after an employee found the mutilated body of Mr. Borough underneath his tractor. Police arrived but were immediately driven away by the tractor. Panic calls to federal authorities were intercepted by Bureau communication staff. A team was dispatched. Upon arrival, the agents approached the item. It responded by growling like a bear. Three agents were injured when they were tried to detain the item, which escaped. Aerial screeches for the item searches for the item are ongoing. Speaking to Mrs. Borrow and revealing that she had a domestic altercation with Miss Borrow earlier the night of the incident, whether these events are connected is currently unknown. Man, there are loads of fucking documents here. But you know, there doesn't seem to be a battery up there. So I think I should be able to. What's that power? Are there any documents in here? Nope. I think I should be able to take that and slap it onto the one up there. Oh, piss off.
Now that gate should open.
Let's hope you're right, Jesse. Oh, another document. Specimen escape something. The purpose of internal investigation X0397 is to examine the containment failure of specimen SI1 that resulted in the death of 7,000 agents. An inspection report of the containment equipment 3 days earlier shows no faults. Investigators suspect human error to be the cause, yet no department has provided any evidence to support this. Technicians were able to recover the researcher's notes on the specimen from the internal network. On the something of something, the specimen began displaying a sharp increase in aggressive behaviors. Cross-referencing that date with various logs found only two events inconsistent with the sector's daily routine. Number one, the air filters were changed, and number two, an hour prior to the incident, a civilian named Alice Field entered the sector regarding an unrelated investigation. Entered the sector. Okay. Given their connection to the same AWU case, it is likely that Mrs. Field's presence is relevant to the specimen's escape to the something. Investigation is ongoing. Okay. Not sure what that's about. It's about the tractor. Alright, cool. A control point.
I'm no detective, but something definitely happened here.
Alright, we can do a three togs to get through there, but first document. The Blessed Organization. Summary, this group/individual has operated outside the Bureau's notice for decades, perhaps longer, displaying a level of skill and caution rarely seen in paracriminal groups. A review of past cases has found various mentions of their activity over the years. In 2016, a production company called Blessed Pictures was connected to an altered item case, as well as the death of an agent from exposure to illicit paranormal materials. In 1994, a Los Angeles-based public speaker named Chester Bless was involved in the legal use of an altered item. That would be the megaphone. In 1988, a business called Blessed Repair and Service was suspected of involvement with an object of power case, perhaps even creating it. None of these businesses or individuals have ever been located. However, their connection to appearances of altered items and objects of power is too direct to be considered circumstantial. An arrest order has been issued for any persons believed to be involved with the Blessed organization. Cool. Let's go.
Do we know each other? I feel this feels familiar. I can't seem to. I've forgotten it. I'm sorry. My name is Alan Wake.
Friend Tom. Tom Zane. There's nothing to worry about.
Tom. The poet. The diver, you look different.
That was just a role. A character. protagonist I played in my old film. I'm a filmmaker, an auteur like yourself. We're working on this together, remember? An artistic collaboration. You need a drink.
My double. He's out there. I've seen
him. Yeah. Nothing to worry about. I'm dealing with him. It's fine, my friend. Let me handle him.
You've met him? What the hell?
Now, come on. You misunderstand me.
Was the Alan Wake, the famous writer? He disappeared years ago. It was all over the news back then. And Thomas Zane was with him. The poet. No, wait. He was a filmmaker. I always remember that wrong.
Oh, I'm so confused. But Thomas Zane looked more like Alan Wake than Alan Wake did. Like, that was crazy. Alright, we've still got a light switch. It's gonna be a locked door, of course. That was Alan Wake's door. Alright, let's see what we're gonna do this time. So do I turn off all of the things that make the noise? I think I picked up the key. Well, I'm not sure. I thought I was, but then the light broke. Alright, I did. Mm-hmm. That's our control point, and now we've got this, which hopefully I can traverse. Thank you. don't know what to do. It's got to be this way.
Wake want me to come here.
Can't believe that was actually what you were meant to do. Telephone. Okay. What, did the telephone survive that? Oh my god. Of course it did. Filing and processing and the operation centers this way. Oh man, what's going on?
That doesn't look like a house shift. Do I even want to know?
Yes. Yes, you do. Got to be praised. Control point. Does that heal me? There goes my kill dudes without dying achievement.
Yeah. in here.
Why wouldn't they be just? Hartman's arrest. Okay, Emil Hartman is the offender. Victim names: Alan Wake, Anderson, Tor, and Anderson. Odin, something, Lane, Rudolph, Desole, or Desol, Wendy, Emerson, Thomas, and something. Officer names: Dennis, Special Agent Remy. Charges: Code 4, kidnapping of altered individuals. Code 8, sanction against altered organization. Code 37, obstruction of Bureau investigation. And 6 counts of Code 74, breaching the Ash Act. Okay, it looks like there's more to this document, but there isn't apparently. Okay, additional notes: offender's property seized as evidence to be used in conjunction with an ongoing AWE investigation. Offender's personal effects have been sent to research for analysis. After being cleared by Bureau and researchers, all victims have been released by annual surveillance. Orders were assigned to each except the Anderson brothers due to being senile, and Wake, who is possibly deceased. Anything in here?
Whoa. House has gotten a little wild in here.
I'm guessing this is the way. No? It's not the way. The firebreak is this way. Oh, but that's where I came from, right? I'm going to film some processing. Why can't I go through there? I hope it hasn't fucking glitched out on me. Service tunnel. Okay. Looks promising.
This darkness is blocking the door. So
oh, wow.
Now I have to deal with the interdimensional noise and sentient shadows. Light burns it away, huh? Makes sense.
Mad. Playing Alan Wake now. Hello. What am I supposed to I remember like voices like that. work. Alright, so I don't want to go there. Oh shit, okay. So that was where I couldn't get through to earlier. Took the long way.
A third thing. The sound made darker, the darkness made louder. Hartman was stretched like a worm through time. The third thing was a monster. Now we crashed out of darkness toward Faden.
Interrogation complaint. Kirkland, so you put me on desk duty just because I did the thing I was fucking hired to do, my job. Want to know what I call that? Bullshit. Asking us to interrogate these con without using words like altered items or OWs or paracriminal is the stupidest thing I've heard in my life, and I've heard some fucking stupid things. They already know the facts. Hell, they know just as much as us, if not more, and they get to sit there laughing at us while we dance around our words trying not to leak classified terminology. They already know the fucking terminology. If you think pulling me off the scape will stop me, then think again. That piece of shit blocked those tracks. He killed those people all to make a train turn altered. We have him dead to rights, and you need to let me back into that interrogation cell so I can get him to flip on his bodies. These people are terrorists and deserve to be treated as such. This won't stop unless we stop them. You can go ahead and put me on suspension. See if that slows me down, Agent Hewitt. Black Market. The Black Market are specialised in the trade of occult talismans, relics and other assorted ceremonial objects, as well as well genuine altered and paranormal materials. Was raided in Something Czech Republic by a team of special investigators. Unsuccessful attempts by suspects to escape using altered items resulted in numerous casualties and prevented the Bureau from questioning all participants. The following interrogations revealed that not only is there a vast network of these retailers, but they seem to be gathering information on altered items and other paranormal material from sources known to the Bureau. The Bureau's concern here is threefold. A, there is a growing underground market of paranormal materials, which implies a growing awareness of their existence among a niche group of the general public. B, these criminal individuals do not seem aware of the items. Paranormal powers and their attempts to activate them could prove devastating if done in populated areas. And C, the motivations of the collectors are largely unknown. Documents.
Darkness everywhere. New day, same old bloody sea.
The plants in here have died standing up.
Lighten them up.
Okay, I've gotten loads of like side missions. Eliminate the darkness, eradicate the mold. And shine lights on the plants. Right, I need some lights, man. I can't rip these. NASA Corporation Review. Following the NASA FPC coordination agreement in 1972, the Bureau has provided NASA with numerous technological advancements based on our research, including the black rock lining now found in all space-faring vessels. In return, all data gathered during space missions is made available for Bureau researchers to analyze. Recently, certain individuals have raised concern that this relationship does not adequately benefit the Bureau, either intellectually or financially. A thorough examination of the costs accrued by both organizations shown that the expense of NASA's recent launch of the Something far outweighs any spending related to the processing and delivery of BlackRock. From its medium Earth orbit, the Something will provide the Bureau with an unparalleled resource for remotely monitoring and photographing AWE sites, a resource that will be lost if the partnership ends. It is the opinion of this committee that maintaining a cooperative relationship with our colleagues at NASA is of vital importance. Okay, this is the way. After investigation, but it's locked, which is fine because I need to do a bunch of stuff. Starting with that darkness upstairs. First, need some light. I know there's a light here somewhere. Or am I wrong?
Reminder, all employees are required to report their hours at the end of each month. The Federal Bureau of Control maintains that time is not subjective, and hours passed on alternative planes cannot be claimed. Astral dives do not accumulate overtime compensation. Thank you for your attention.
Seriously, I can't find a single light source. I can't find that. Okay, I could have just walked it. Summary. Event summary. Obtained derailment resulting in 62 casualties and numerous injuries suspected to have been the work of a parent criminal group known as Angel or whatever they were called. As a result of this event, the agents discovered that one of the cars has become altered with a persistent auditory event. It remains to be determined whether the AWE was spontaneous or the direct result of the sabotage. Event response. The Bureau has been tracking said group at the time of the intel gathering suggested an event of this caliber was imminent in Bloomington. As a result, a response team on site was able to respond to the train accident site within minutes of its occurrence. They arrived to find emergency processes underway, but also equipment left behind by the suspected group. A suspicious onlooker managed to elude agents after they attempted to make contact. Further investigations of the accident site revealed a curiously undamaged train car that exhibited an altered state when entered. This individual car was secured and transported to the investigation section for further details. Cool. Train car.
Understanding of the darkness is fragmented, incomplete. This abyss, this void, it very much does not wish to be understood. If light symbolizes knowledge, then it stands to reason that darkness would equate to ignorance. By its very nature, it abhors comprehension. Of course, my own nature drives me to comprehend all. We are opposing forces.
Sorry, I shouldn't have picked that up so quickly. Examination paranormal entities, the shadow. Paranormal entity A010, aka the shadow, is an aggressive something consisting of three known types. Type A, localized manifestations of sentient beings capable of occupying organic and inorganic material as well as exerting something over its surroundings. Type B, shaded individuals, human bodies infested by the shadows. These individuals become noticeably more aggressive but do seem to retain humanity of their previous form, of their previous selves. Research is ongoing as to whether this condition is reversible. Type C, shaded objects, similar to type B, except that inanimate objects are something solely to be used as destructive tools. Each type seems to work towards a shared goal, possibly targeting certain individuals, which may imply a shared link to a something, a hive intelligence. The threat this entity poses warrants immediate exploration of offensive and slash defensive measures. The investigation sector is being outfitted with additional lighting sources, some internally powered to prepare for the eventuality of a something.
Destined to collide. And given this conflict of natures, we know that the light of truth will burn away the darkness, both figuratively and literally. Any significant light source can be used as protection, even weaponry, against this metaphysical gloom. Where are the artists? I know for a fact that Tom, Wake, the Anderson brothers, and Lane all had some involvement with the darkness. The question is whether their uncanny ability to affect reality through their art beckons the darkness, or did their work perhaps even is Wake now secure in my lodge? I expect I shall grow closer to learning the answers to these questions. Assuming he cooperates, which is proving quite the challenge. Well, perseverance is the foundation of knowledge. Speaking of, I must be off on my rounds.
Alright.
Inside the motel. Utilized surveillance methods are as follows. Fiber optic cameras slid under the individual room doors. Motion detectors in the lobby area.
Okay.
Tripwire.
Thanks for joining.
A flash camera across the main entrance.
Bye.
Even fingerprint powder on the front desk. Results are varying at best. But mostly just inconclusive and unusable. The footage is corrupted. Sometimes even the equipment is damaged. So I don't know how. Closed doors. I could hear the call bell going ding multiple times a day, but when I look, there's no one here. I know I'm supposed to stay out of sight, but I've seen the doors closing just before I can catch even a glimpse of anyone or anything. They're messing with me, whoever they are. I think. Wait. Shh. There's something. I gotta get this. Gotta get the cable.
Too many artifacts in this game, man. This is a lot of side quests.
I don't feel right. Something in this darkness is draining me.
Mid-battle document, Night Spring, spec script. Oh shit, the screenplay was found after the Bureau acquired the Night Springs television series and all its past episode scripts. It appears to be written by Alan Wake as part of an application to become one of the show's writers. Episode 1, Festival of Darkly, host voiceover, it is only human nature to wish to control the forces around us. And even more so, so to possess them, but what happens when those forces are not ours to claim, or even in this world? What if they are the things you can discover in Night Springs? Int Secret Lab, Night, we are in Secret Lab, the large sign on the wall reads Federal Bureau of Night Springs. Scientists have told you several times, Director, it isn't ready. It is ready when I say it is, Doctor, but but the being beyond the portal, we have no control over it. This sounds like the FTC, right? Any ports here? Do a port map. Documents instead, Hartman's background. Dr. Emil Hartman is an academic psychotherapist that owned and operated in a recovery center in, Echo Falls or whatever it was called, focused on the treatment of artists struggling with creative blocks and other mental disorders. Publicly, Dr. Hartman's treatment center seemed unremarkable in its methods and purpose. Privately owned, however, Dr. Hartman was abusing his patients in order to utilize any latent something psychic abilities they may possess, with the aim of shaping something to his own benefit, which has earned him a Class 2 paracriminal designation. Okay. Investigations have proven that Dr. Hartman's illegal endeavors were conducted alone after being approached by the Bureau during the something investigation. He displayed no remorse or intention to cease his actions. Dr. Hartman was taken into custody, evaluated, and released months later, having been deemed a negligible threat. His medical license being permanently revoked. Thank God it's not a problem. Oh, I'm guessing that's
Hartman. Yeah, how do you like that?
God, man. All this for a document. And now that I'm here, I can't fucking pick it up. Makes sense, apparently. Ocean View Motel observation report and excursion into the Ocean View Motel and Casino discovered a previously unseen door in the lobby halfway. This door featured a spiral-shaped marking similar to the other doors. It is locked and cannot be opened. Alright, Alice Wake, a personal... Oh shit, Alice Wake. What was that in before? A person of interest in the Bright Falls AWE and the former wife of missing author Alan Wake contacted Agent Shaw and Dempsey of the investigation sector using the phone number given to her in 2010 in accordance to civilian outreach protocols. The call resulted in Mrs. Wake being brought into the oldest house for an in-person interview. In 2017, the excursion into the Ocean View Motel occurred later that same day. Conclusion, determining whether this is a basic synchronicity event, if Alice Wake is responsible for his appearance or if the door itself relates to AWE 35, is paramount. She should be returned to the oldest house, possibly even taken into the motel itself to confirm if any other changes occur. Alright. Well, that's some great information, but I could really do with some health. He went into the thing, but I don't think I'm going to follow him into the thing. I'm going to go to the operation center instead. There's my health. Oh, astral constructs. What can I make? A new weapon form? Surge. Surge fires adhesive munitions that detonate when manually triggered or if their timer expires. Okay, that's cool. Let's need some more sauce and I can make that. Lost in the sauce. Okay, I came from here, right? So it will be... the lift now. I can use it. Right.
What are you doing in investigations?
Jesus, don't scare me like that, Langston.
If you're talking right now, I can't hear you. It's a one-way system. Try to find an intercom.
Langston, it's me, Jesse.
I know. I can see you on the monitors. The cameras in there haven't worked since we sealed that sector off a couple years back.
Let me guess. You sealed it because of the monster guy.
Wait, did you see Dr. Hartman? Jesus, I really wish you hadn't opened that fire break. Okay, listen, you need to find Hartman and kill him before he gets out into the Bureau.
That thing is a person?
He was a person. We brought him here to study after he was, altered in an AWE. I forget the medical word for what happened, but now light physically hurts him. Do you have a flashlight?
No.
A lantern? Headlamp? Oh yeah, flare gun. Oh, Christmas lights. You could wrap them around your...
I don't have any of those, Langston.
Shit. Okay, well, I'm sure you'll think of something. I'll keep an eye on you from the Panopticon. This is kind of exciting, right?
Maybe from where you're standing.
Right, okay. Well, break a leg. Oh, why did I say that?
Okay, this Hartman thing can't have gotten very far.
What's that for? Flight of Hartman.
Let's go flush him out.
Alright, this
Langston
is like...
Langston was right.
DLC
this
level.
This is kind of exciting.
It's just nice to have someone to talk to, you know?
So...
ever since I got put in charge of the Panopticon, people treat me different. Like I'm crazy for wanting to work with altered items.
So you know what? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna call it here. I need to go and do something for my dad, right?
Very empathetic mind to connect with the items.
I wish this guy would fuck up.
Brag.
I'm trying to talk it.
So
but yeah, I'm gonna call
right.
it here. And I think
I mean,
on the next session when
I
come back, I'm just gonna go on and do the main quest because I just want to get that over and done with. Hopefully that doesn't stop me from doing this side quest. But maybe I should just finish it off. I might just finish it off in the next session and then go back to the main quest. But yeah, it's like, whoa man, some of these side quests are like long as hell. But yeah, okay, cool. Thanks for joining guys, and I will speak to you guys very, very soon, possibly even tomorrow. I think probably tomorrow I'll come back and play this because I'm back into it now and I just want to like keep that momentum going. So yeah, peace out and have a good evening.